As creative agencies, I think we've tapped into syndicated and research data sources for some time now. There's always been a research component to creative agencies. I think what's different now is that we're using identity-based data that is actually allowing us to travel with an individual and understand how they live and what motivates them throughout their day to consume different brands. So for instance, I'm able to now, with our Agile data platform at Omnicom, we're able to track people at the individual level. So Andy, I could find out that maybe in the early in the morning, you go and you get your coffee and you buy that from a specific brand, and then you go to work and you get online and you seem to be, you know, having certain types of websites or brands or things like that you expose yourself to. Or you might be consuming certain content, certain news or videos or things like that. Maybe you like videos of dancing cats, I don't know. And then you go on through the rest of your day, and we're able to stitch together a profile that's not a static view of you, male, you know, X, all these other things kind of about you, but now it's a very dynamic way of looking at your life. And so in there, we can find opportunities and moments to tap into when we should be saying things to you in different mediums or different locations, right? Am I gonna do it now to home? That's the media question, right? But what and why? Why are you doing the things that you do? Why are you consuming the brands that you consume? Why are you consuming the certain content? And what's motivating you that we can use that will help us help brands to find an ownable, distinctive, and very authentic place to engage with you?
So how does that work in sort of an optimized fashion? Kind of, in other words, you kind of know Andy, but you also know Joe, and you have a big brand marketer. How does creativity sort of take into account all these different identities?
Well, the thing is, we're not looking at every single Andy, right? We're finding all people who are like Andy and grouping them together and calling them an audience, right? So that audience, say we have a particular brand. A brand has a certain audience they're usually trying to get. Well, we don't look at it as an audience anymore. We look at it as audiences. So there's multiple different audiences that are scaled, right, and sized that allow us to know that it's big enough that it's actually going to move your business. Now, what do I say to these different audiences based on their specific motivations and the specific ways that they want to engage with the category and specifically for your brand?
Let me ask you about dynamic creative and sort of, there's been a lot of talk about it, a lot of promise. You know, what are your thoughts and what are you guys doing?
I think it has its place. I don't think it should be the only thing that you do, but what I do like about programmatic creative, because you're able to iterate so many different versions of messaging or different types of things, it's a great place to test with different audiences what's actually going to not just resonate with them, but get them to drive to action. So it is one of those places where it's really a good testing bed for creative, but also I think I think eventually one day, as machine learning and AI comes to its maturity, we're going to be building a lot more dynamic and programmatic experiences for people. We're not going to be just delivering ads. We're going to be delivering whole experiences that surround the consumer that they're going to want to engage in because they're so enjoyable. They resonate for them on an emotional level. They give them a sense of you're with them, which is where we really want to be with our brands versus talking at people and not really knowing who they are.